Now the next step is to learn about the different instructions. There are many, many instructions, so let's stick with some of the basics for now. The timer in the PLC is represented as T. The timer contact does not close until its coil has been energized for a preset period of time. For example, if you set timer T0 as 100, T0 contact will not turn on until after T0 coil has been energized for 10 seconds. This is used to program a delay. Example in GXWorks 2. Move the cursor next to the contact and press F7. Then enter symbol will pop up. Now enter T0 space K100 and enter. A timer coil will appear on the screen. To the right of the coil, you will see K100, which means the operation will start after 10 seconds. Next is the counter. The counter is represented as C. A counter counts the number of times that the contact is driven. When the number in the counter reaches a preset number, the counter contact turns on. Example in GXWorks 2. Move the cursor next to the contact and press F7. Enter C space K10, then press Enter. This time, a counter coil will appear on the screen. To the right of the coil, you will see K10, which means that it will count up to 10. The set instruction forces an internal relay to be latched. We use the reset instruction to reset a relay latched by the set instruction. The reset instruction is also used to reset the counter and timer. Example in GXWorks 2. Move the cursor next to the contact and press F8. Enter set space Y0, then press Enter. A box that says set Y0 will appear on the screen. The latch circuit is similar to the set reset instructions. One input drives an output, which latches. Another input breaks the latch. We saw this in the last chapter. So, we have studied a few of the most popular instructions. There are hundreds more, although most users will use only a fraction of them. All instructions are described in the PLC user's manual, and how to use them is basically the same. By studying other instructions, you will get a better understanding about PLC.